The Pentagon plans to reveal just how many servicemen are currently on the ground in Syria. Officially, U.S. military has close to 500 soldiers in the country. The number is believed to be closer to 2,000. So which is it? The announcement comes as Russia pushes ahead with plans to settle the Syrian conflict, which began back in 2011. Russian President Vladimir Putin recently met with Turkey's President Erdogan and Iran's Rouhani to lay out a roadmap for the future, politically, of Syria. Meanwhile, the UN Special Envoy to Syria says Tuesday's talks in Geneva will focus on setting up future elections in the war-torn country. For more on this, we turn to Michael Maloof tonight, former Pentagon official. Michael, nice to have you with us.
Thank you, Ed.
Explain these special forces. Why are there different numbers? Well, our presence in Syria must be real at some level.
It is very real. It's illegal, technically, because neither the government of Syria nor the U.S. Congress has approved it, yet the U.S. plans to stay. They're increasing the numbers of troops. They've been increasing. They're not going to reveal the numbers because of for security reasons, but there are a lot more. The feeling is that the U.S. military will settle in Kurdish-controlled areas. But that seems to be a little complicated by the fact that Turkey has prevailed upon President Trump to no longer arm the Kurds. So the question is, what's the U.S. strategy long term?
Is this a roundabout way of the United States still respecting the independent vote of the Kurdish people, that might not be a dead horse yet?
It's never a dead horse. We do recognize the Kurds' a contribution to fighting ISIS. After all, they were the main ground troops. I think what the U.S. is trying to do is establish a base there, pretty much also to do one outside of Mosul in Iraq. The notion is to try and unite the Sunnis as well as the Syrian opposition, even though you have a political process underway not only in Geneva, but you also have further complications by the fact Iran has just now announced that it plans to set up a base in Syria. And then that throws in yet another ingredient in all of this, and that is Saudi Arabia's recent stance of aggressive discussion against Iran. And you also have Israel, which is next door, will not tolerate Iran's presence any longer in Syria, let alone Lebanon, because of Hezbollah.
It sounds like the United States has made the decision, well, we've got to have troops somewhere. Mm-hmm. We've got to have a presence somewhere, just in case. Mm-hmm. I mean, these U.S. Special Forces before were training the rebels. Mm-hmm. Well, Assad's not going anywhere,
no,
although at the White House press meeting today, the press spokesperson said that their position on Syria hasn't changed when it comes to Assad. There's just so much conflicting information here from the standpoint of where is the United States?
Well, there is a conflict even in what the U.S. position toward Assad is. You have Tillerson saying we're no longer out for regime change. On the other hand, you hear Nikki Haley, the U.N., U.S. Representative at the U.N., saying he's got to go. You've got the Syrian opposition, which is supposed to be meeting sometime soon in Geneva, which basically wants Assad out, even though they have they're not pushing that, although that's their intention. It's going to be a long, festering fight. And then you have the Russian ingredient of trying to come to a political solution in Syria. And given all these outside complications, you still have outside powers that are going to be affecting this.
Which Trump and Putin have talked about, that
yes,
political
they have.
Solution.
Yes,
Michael
they have.
Maloof, thanks for joining us
Thank
tonight.
You.
Appreciate it.